Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good day, everyone. We're in the first 10 days of Zhul hijjah, and there are a few things I want to share with you guys. Okay, first is fasting. Fasting is highly recommended for us in this first 10 days of Zhul hijjah. Not really, you can't really fast the whole 9 days. No. If you're privileged, you can do that. But if you can't, at least fast on the day of Arafah. And also fasting, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, that fast all deeds of son of Adam are for him, except fasting, which is for me, and I will reward for it abundantly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that fasting is the only act of worship that he will reward for us alone. Not really that the others don't matter, but fasting is for him alone and not for anybody else. Okay, and also fasting, especially on the day of Arafah, which is included in these 9 days of Dhul Hijjah, is recommended for us Muslims to fast also. I urge you, myself and you also, to please fast on the day of Arafah, because the Prophet ﷺ has told us that fasting on the day of Arafah is an expiation for sins of son of Adam of 2 years. That is the previous and the following year. So please we should fast, especially on the day of Arafah. If you are not privileged and you can't, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see your heart and he will reward you for that intention that you have for the fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us. And then secondly is the qurban, the sacrifice of a livestock animal. Qurban is a sacred act of worship that is done in specified days. That is the 10th, 11th and the 12th. Day of Dhul Hijjah, we Muslims will sacrifice the livestock animal in order to attain piety from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know the story where Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked to slaughter his son, Prophet Ismail alayhi salam. He chose to do that because it pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he tried to do that, he chose. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has seen his heart because he wasn't reluctant. He almost sacrificed his son, where a ram was substituted for his son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed every eligible Muslim that is privileged to do that on the day of Eid. That is the 10th day of Dhul Hijjah. So please, we should try to do that. And also, it is not the meat nor the blood that reaches Allah. It is the piety from our heart that reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, we should try to do this also. Then we have the adhkar. We have to remember and glorify Allah wherever we are. You can say the tahmid, the tahleel, the istighfar, anywhere you are. Tahleel is la ilaha illallah, and tahmid is alhamdulillah, tasbih is subhanallah, and istighfar is astaghfirullah. You can keep repeating these words over and over, 1,000, 1,000,000 times a day without getting really tired. It is the simplest act of ibadah. Actually, for me, it's the simplest. Because you can do it wherever you are, while driving, while cooking, while doing the house chores, or while in the class waiting for a lecture, or maybe you're in a meeting waiting for something. When you're quite alone, you're sitting alone, you can glorify Allah wherever you are. That is permissible to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then last but not the least is do more good deeds than usual. That is, we should also strive to do more of good deeds than usual, than our usual days. That is like reading the Quran, giving the sadaqah. Giving sadaqah does not mean that you only have to give out some amount of money. No, you can do the various acts of sadaqah. Maybe you can take something that is harmful away from the road, or you can take away something, or you can smile to a fellow brother. Sadaqah is a very simple act of worship. So it is something as simple as a smile to a fellow brother or a sister. So I urge every Muslim to please do more good deeds than usual. You can read the Quran abundantly, because every half has 10 reward. For every half, there's a 10 reward. For every alphabet in the Quran that she recites, it has 10 rewards allocated to it. So please, we should strive and endeavor to do this. I urge myself and you to do this abundantly. And you can make much dua. You can be kind and honor your parents more in these 10 days, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for that. You can make much dua. Dua has no veil from Allah. You can supplicate to Allah, you can ask Him, you can thank Him for all the ni'mah that He has given to you. you can do that. That is also a dua. If you thank him, you are almost making a dua to him. So please, we should try and endeavor to do, to make much dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.